have three beautiful art museums. This is a museum of sculpture directly in front of us. This was the private estate of a 20th century sculptor. A young man came to America at the age of 20. He came here from Czechoslovakia, and he studied in America in Philadelphia. And for 30 years, he was a teacher of sculpture at the Art Institute in downtown Chicago, the Institute of Art. One of the most beautiful museums in America, the Art Institute in Chicago, Illinois. And he retired here, and his private home is now a museum. 200 works of Polashek sculpture on display. This in the next hour. Bananas and bamboo. Now this was a creek, a brook. It was made into a canal in the year 1890. It can hold 6 feet of water. Cabeza, watch your cabeza, okay? What part of India are y'all from? Pardon? Okay. Careful. Low bridge here. All right. Everybody duck. Duck your head. Duck, duck. Cabeza. Okay. Bamboo. We're 95 feet above sea level. 95 feet. This is one of the highest elevations in Florida. No swamps here. All the land is good for building. This is a 100-year-old oak tree on the left. The plant on the tree is called Spanish moss. No harm to the tree. This is the south end of the city. The city is small, 8 square miles. There is a Lake Lago Maisel on the other side. Lake Maisel on the other side. The house was built in 1920. The structure to the left is a guest house, separate guest house to the left. Fishing here in the lakes. Bass, B-A-S-S, largemouth bass. $6 million, the White House, $6 million. Seis millones. The previous owner was a newspaper heiress from California by the name of Scripps, the Scripps newspaper family. The new family, one of their daughters goes to Rollins College, which is on the other side of the lake, is Rollins College. In the school year, she lives over there. She could swim home for a meal if she wants. These lakes are 80 degree water right now.
$10 million.
Two people, $10 million. In 1938, Now look for peacocks. We have wild peacocks here. Peacocks were turned loose here in 1950. The villa was completed in 1938, 78 years old. It's a peacock on the wall. See, yeah. See him on the wall there? There he is. Hear him? Sounds like a cat. National bird of what country?
India.
Yeah, you guys better know that one, huh? I wanted to see you. I was trying to trip you up, see if you knew it. But that's right. National bird of India, the peacock. Beautiful bird. That was the home for the president of Rollins College for many years. The last to live there was President McCain in the year 1999. So no one's living there now. It's used for faculty meetings. They have a new house for the president. I'll show you that in a few minutes. This is 40 acres. All this green to your left, 40 acres. This is the largest piece of undeveloped land in the city, 40 acres. Casa, su casa. 12 million. Took 3 years to build it. 12 million. Two people.
Wow.
Now this is Lake Virginia. There are three lakes here. This is Lake Virginia, Lake Sioux, and Lake Mizell. So we're going to visit here a little bit, and then we're going to take you up to the north. This is Rollins College, 1885. 2,000 students from 60 countries. This is the top liberal arts college in Florida, top 50 in the country. The students are from 60 countries, including Singapore. Condominiums, 1961. You can see three lakes from the top. To your left is older than America. That tree is over 300 years old. It's an oak tree. It can live for 600 years. This is bamboo to the left. We are moving to the north. The city is north to south, 8 square miles. This is very comfortable in the canal. This is going to take us to the north. El Norte. Bananas. Puente, 1920 bridge. And you see a new home, an old house was torn down. Whoa. Alligator.
Huh?
Big alligator.
Big alligator.
I just ran over.
Uh-oh.
Got a headache now. Dolor de la cabeza. You don't know if I'm telling the truth or not. No, just kidding. No more gators here. I see a little one once in a while. Big gators were taken out 20 years ago. Put them in Lake Jessup, straight ahead. Miles ahead, Lake Jessup.
Let's go.
Most alligator infested lake in Florida. This is the North Lake, and it's the biggest lake, 500 acres. called Lake Maitland. Our neighbor is the city of Maitland, and that is the green in the front is the city of Maitland. The deepest part of this lake is 40 feet. This is a 9-acre neighborhood park established 1936. Weddings are held here year-round, even during the weekdays we have weddings here. This 9-acre park was a gift from George and Maud Kraft, K-R-A-F-T. They lived in the neighborhood and they owned a bank in downtown Orlando. They were not cheese people. A lot of new money here and a lot of new homes. 50 miles that way is the Space Center, Cape Canaveral, 50 miles. This was an elegant hotel over to the right from 1920 to 1980. It had 75 guest rooms. It was called the Alabama Hotel. It operated October to May. It had no air conditioning, so it was closed in the summers. Today it's private, 19 condominiums in the building. This family owned the Tupperware company. It was the daughter of the founders of Tupperware. And that boathouse is new. It has a dining room and a kitchen on the second floor. This is Via Tuscany, and there is a tennis court in front of the white wall, a kitchen and a swimming pool to your right, and to your left, a guest house, two-story, separate quarters for guests. This is going to be a private home at 20,000 square feet, and it's going to be an American colonial. They paid $4 million for the land. Mediterranean's in Winter Park, 1928. Tom Hanks, the movie guy, lived here in 1998. He was making a movie for 4 months. It was called From the Earth to the Moon. This was his headquarters. And he put the house, a little cameo shot of the house in the movie. It was a documentary called From the Earth to the Moon, HBO miniseries about the Apollo moon program. It was built in 1920. There are 11 homes on a 12-acre man-made island. It's called the Isle of Sicily. The lakes are going to come up. We don't know how high they're going to come up, but they're guaranteed they will rise. There is a dam that takes the pressure off the lakes. If the water gets too high, the water goes over a dam, and then it goes into the St. John's River. Thank you. that, huh? The gray wall is the swimming pool and the guest house. Triangular roof is the guest house. The biggest home in the city, the white one, 28,000 square feet, $15 million before furniture. Now the house that was donated to the museum at a cost of $1 million came from this, where the new house is. This is the replacement house with the white chimney. It's a very narrow lot. It's a deep lot, but it's narrow, and the architect designed a one-car garage. The one-car garage has an elevator that takes the cars under the ground to four different levels of underground parking. This house has a volleyball court and a swimming pool to the left. A little yellow building, there's a water pump in there for the lawn. This is the oldest boathouse out here, 1888, Victorian style. Big estate is owned by the Morse family. You all come down Morse Boulevard to the boat tour, M-O-R-S-E. Sounds like Mickey Mouse, M-O-U-S-E. 10 years ago,